Essentially accentuate the fear and struggle of a people who have made a change or who would like to make a change in their lives. The exhilarating, soul-stirring play, 28th Purple, is about the main character, Celie, who struggles to find God. Sit back and relax as the class of 2018 presents Purple.
You want to stay out with the color purple?
I want to
we just want to stay out here with you. I love spending time with my sister.
I love you, man.
I love you too.
See? Get out of here, come in the house.
Come on.
Hey.
Let's go. Dear God, I'm 14 years old. Can I have a son? Maybe you can tell me why these things are happening to me. I got two kids, Dennis and Purple. I don't know why I named you Purple. All I remember was one day I was out in the field with my sister Nettie, and she wanted to stay out with the color purple. I still don't know what that means. She said life would have to tell me. But how can this life that I live tell about purple? I heard Potter gave my baby away. Then I heard Ma die when she heard the news. They say she died from a broken heart. It's unkilter. Then I hear that mister wanna marry my daddy. I don't like that mister. He looks like an evil man. His eyes be just a twitching. Please don't let mister marry my sister. Please, dear God.
Now, Alfonso, come out here for a moment. Need to speak with you.
What's up?
You gonna marry your daughter?
Who?
Nettie.
Nettie? See, I can't get you Nettie, but I have another one in mind.
After my wife and run off, these kids been running amok in my house. Need somebody to comb their hair, cook for them, look after them. That's why I need you, Nettie.
See, I can't give you Nettie. I have another girl in mind. Her name's Sid. She can cook, clean, do everything you ask her.
I ain't never really looked at Sid like that. I ain't even know she was your daughter.
See, I remember my days. Decision without me, but she didn't do it.
Well, can I see this girl you talking about?
Silly! Come on down here. One of my church folks want to meet with you.
Alfonso. That's a girl? Turn around. Stop. Arms out. Nah, these arms ain't carrying nothing.
Legs ain't moving nothing.
Oh, hell no, Alfonso. This girl stank. Smell like barbecue sauce.
See?
Nah, she ain't what I want. Now bring out Nettie.
Look, Sid, question. You cook, right?
Yes, sir.
You clean?
Yes, sir.
You can wash out some little chili, right?
Yes, sir.
Nah, come here, we gonna speak about this. Cause she ain't what I want.
Dear God, looks like Mr. might get to have me. He inspected me like I'm a mule or something. All I can do is think about my sister, Nettie. If this man take me, will I ever be able to see my Nettie again? Part of me glad I was gone, because at least she ain't got to. I'll show enough to do it for. answer me. At least she ain't gotta go. But I didn't know I was gonna be the one taking her place. Please, protect Ned. If this man takes me.
Now, Alfonso, I done told you I don't like her. I don't want it. She ugly. She stink.
Look! You see, either you gonna take her, or you can leave.
Well, I do got a phone, Warren. You say she could cook and clean. I'll take it.
You hear that? You about to marry this man. Pack your bags. Say goodbye to your sister and get off my house.
Wash my clothes. Pa, you couldn't find anybody better than her? But I was looking at his sister, but that wasn't gonna work out.
It ain't gonna work out now. She still ain't my mom.
She ain't got it either.
Hey, Celia, come out there, comb that child's hair. And see the knots from over here.
Showing love.
Yes, I'm beautiful.
Going to the store. By the time I get back, that back room
but clean. You understand?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Nettie, you can come out now. He's gone.
Pregnant or something?
Yes, I am.
about what?
Hopper.
And how you know that?
Excuse me? I don't get down like that.
I'm gonna get this shit up out my house. I don't like her. She nasty.
Now, Pa, I know what you think. I can handle it.
Don't know about all that.
But I think I'm ready to go.
I will get up out my house.
I do. Come on. We leave.
Uncle, you better take one step.
Thank you. At least somebody in this house got some class. Hop up. I said let's go.
Oh, you ain't going nowhere.
Hop up. I said let's go. I ain't going to say it again. Hop up. I said let's go. And I ain't going to say it again.
Pop, I got it.
Boy ain't got no balls. Where did I go wrong? I gotta talk to this boy about this Sophia sitting in my house. Ridiculous. She nasty, disrespectful. Wrong to be a woman. She's stubborn. Matter of fact, next time I see her, Hope, let her know he got 2 weeks to get up out of my house. And I don't care if she's pregnant or not, they all get up out of here.
Take care of this house, talk to you later.
Was that Sophia fussing?
You know it was. She always fussing about something.
Well, what isn't she doing?
She ain't minding me, like you do my pa. What you suppose I should do?
Beat up.
I can't believe I got that car groceries. Where did I put it? Just see, come on, move. Look.
You know what? I'm glad you came back. Because I'm not done talking to you.
Well, we just had a perfectly good understanding.
I don't think we did, Sophia.
Well, I didn't.
Sophia, you gonna listen to me?
You don't leave me alone. It's your friends. I know you might just put your hands to me. Did you do something? Who told you to put your hands on me?
Silly did.
For some they come in with a tie, for others they serve
had every male wish yes, on board. For some, they come in with the tide.
You got to see it.
For others, they stay forever on the horizon. Never out of sight, never landed, until the watcher turns his eyes away in resignation. I don't like this. Reading is hard. It makes me tired.
You gotta keep fighting, Susie. I wanna teach you to read, so if we ever get separated, I can watch your weapons. So we'll never be lost, or if they'll touch. Only that can you read for me.
I
love you too, too.
7 months to write, and I put a lot of different things in The Color Purple, different monologues. We're gonna take a, hey Nick,
what's up,
my son, We're gonna take a quick intermission. Let's say about, let's do what? 10 minutes? Okay. 2 minutes? No. Let's do a 10-minute intermission and then we'll get started with Act Two.
Okay.
Refrigerated.
You made this? You better take it out of my hand before I throw it at you.
I got you. I'll redo it.
Albert.
I'm coming.
I'm going to move my brain. What you looking at? You never seen a beautiful woman before? By the way, you not looking.
Yes, I am. You said it when you first came. You sure is ugly.
Come here.
Don't you touch that mailbox. I had it fixed. I can tell whether or not somebody been messing with it.
I ain't gonna mess with you, mister.
Out! It's my house!
I hear you got that woman in this house. She is a nasty woman. She has set the population of this town into an all-new high. All her babies got different daddies.
All Sugar's babies got the same daddy.
You a same daddy liar. She done got at least 5 baby daddies. Even her own daddy don't want nothing to do with her. Not that she got that nasty.
Shug ain't got no diseases. And Sealy, take that water back. He ain't gonna be drinking it. He's leaving soon.
I gave you this house. You don't own this house. This is still my land. I come and go whenever I feel like it. Miss Sealy, my hat goes off to you. Not too many women allow their man's mistress live in this here house. And I'll take that cup of water, because I was staying for a while.
Why does everybody feel like they can just walk up in my house?
We just had this conversation. This isn't your house.
What? This ain't your house?
I couldn't tell the way you boss everyone around here, and this ain't your house. How do you do? I'm Miss Sophia.
Nice to meet you. Unfortunately, I was gone.
Who's out?
This little boy right here. Look, I don't know what he got going on, but he gotta get that Sugar Gabriel out of my house. She is bad news. I don't want her in this house.
I heard somebody say my name. Look who it is. This grumpy old man.
Sugar, I ain't sugarcoating anything. I didn't like you when my son tried to marry you, and I don't like you now. I actually came to see why you did.
Who do you want phone?
Well, it's not my fault because I came with this, all of this. No man came with all this.
All right.
Well, I can't. I can't look at you without thinking I'm going to catch something.
Oh. Alba, you need to get your father. I heard you do it. I'm gonna go.
Is that what my book is? I've been hearing nonstop. Juke joint things. Juke joint things. What type of woman do you have to juke joint?
Woman like Shirley
Avery. I swear to God.
I think it's about time for everybody to get up out my house and take themselves to the juke joint. I made you. I gave you a son.
Child, please.
Sophia. You ain't leaving me. Sophia! Sophia!
Please come back.
Sophia, please.
Mail came a little bit later than usual.
Anything come for me?
Now you know ain't nothing come for you, Celia. Don't nobody even know you exist.
Sophia left.
She left? Where's she gone?
She said she leave.
Leave? That's good, son. She wasn't the right one for you to know how. Boy, bring it in. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Uncle, is that a bruise I see on your face?
A bruise? Oh, this ain't no bruise, Pop.
What is it?
Just some mud. You know the mules out in the back? Yeah, they got a little vibe just flinging around mud.
That don't look like no mud or no mule print, boy.
It is.
Don't let me find out Miss Sophia been beaten. You know I ain't raised no women.
Mister, I can throw that extra mail away.
You better not touch my mail. It ain't for you. Don't nobody write you. Don't nobody know about you. Matter of fact, you go ahead and read my mail right now.
Oh,
raise you as your stepmother.
Oh, it's too much in one day.
Oh, well, it's about time you find out the truth. It's been a hell of a long day.
Thank you.
This next song I'm gonna say is for Miss Steele. Miss Steele, you knocked this song out of me when I was sick, and I wanna thank you for that. This song's for you. I really love you, Miss Steele. I really do. And I thank you.
Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And the Lord said, all things can come again.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what you have done. Can I get an amen? There's nothing too hard for our God. He can be the help in your time of need. He can be the doctor for those who are sick. He can be the lawyer for those who are in trouble. You don't have to work too hard to get to our God. Now turn to your neighbor and say, the Lord will order my steps.
Thank you. This too. I've been.
Yeah.
the arrangements yet?
Yes. Y'all been mighty kind, except that father of yours.
Well, he ain't been kind to nobody. I want to make sure you're safe on your trip.
I'll be back soon, Miss Sylvia. I got to go.
She'll be back. She always be back.
God is inside.
that's been taken away from me. I gotta go. I gotta make this for dinner.
Where you going now? Send my mother to the church. I'm probably never
going to
see
them.
They're going
to
make me work for this, Miss
Smith. Welcome to the life of the black woman inside. This life is set up for us to be down under.
Now, we ain't going to be down under for long. Now, you go on now. Send my love to the children.
Father Sophia.
Grandma Sid.
Celia, where you been at? I've been sitting here waiting. I need a shave. Go ahead and get the razor ready.
Miss Sophia said that you gotta do what you gotta do. What looks like I gotta do what I gotta do. Even if that means I'm the one sitting in jail.
Come on, Celia.
I'm coming. This shave ain't gonna be so perfect. You ain't gonna need another one.
Luggage. Moving like molasses. You're dumb. You're ugly, you're built funny. I'd have been better off marrying a rat, or a hog, or a dog. Some with some shame. I bet a dog would be better than you. Come on now, see what they got all day. Ugly self.
I am dead, but I am not.
Hey, Shug.
Hey, Shug.
Oh, man, won't you just let up? I am who I am. You're standing by me.
Paul, please just let him alone.
Please? Matter of fact, I'm married now.
Married?
Yes, married. I'd like to introduce my husband to y'all.
Happy one, I'm free. I've heard nothing but great things about you. So, by the way, where's Miss Silly?
She right here.
Yes, Miss Silly. I've heard nothing but great things about you.
Well, when you going back to Memphis?
Today. And I wanted to let you know that I'm taking Silly with me.
Say Cecilia, over my dead body.
Your dead body, my skin welcome that I need.
What you say?
You heard me. You a low-down dog. A low-down dirty dog. And your dead body might just be the welcome mat that I need. It's time for me to leave this place and end the creation.
And you can't talk to my boy like that.
Your boy? See, that's the problem. He's a boy, and not a boy.
See, now you talking crazy, Steely.
I ain't talking crazy. You took my sister Nettie away from me. You knew that she was the only person who loved me.
You know, I got kids, and they come home to me.
Kids? See, what you talking about? You know you ain't got no children.
Yes, I do. Two of them. Dennis and Parker. And I can't wait for us to get together. Because when we do, us together gonna whoop your ass!
You want what?
You heard me. I can't wait for us to get together. Because when we do, us gonna whoop your ass!
I am the man in this house!
And I'm the woman!
And I got children. They live in Africa. Learn different languages and stuff. They get plenty of exercise.
They much better than these low-down, goofing-up, dirty children you tried to raise.
Hold on, Miss Silly.
No, you hold on, Hoppo. Y'all were evil children. Y'all were. Y'all made my life here live in hell. Y'all treated me so bad. And you know, if you didn't try to rule over Sophia, the white people would have never got to us.
That's a lie. That is a lie.
You are the lie, Hoppo. Y'all were rotten kids. Y'all were. But the apple does not fall far from the tree. Your daddy ain't nothing but horse crap. You ain't nothing but horse crap.
Miss Cindy, you keep talking like that, go have me laughing for the rest of my life.
Well, I'm gonna beat it out of you, and you ain't getting none of my.
Right.
your dreams. Pack your stuff. Leave the sugar. Learn from me. I spent almost 30 years down under. But some things have changed. And that change starts with me.
Max and Rose.
Come on. You gonna let this woman cuss you out of my house? You sitting at the head of the city. I knew I raised you better than that.
You ain't nothing but horses, crap. Any more letters from Nettie come for me?
Letters? You've been messing with my mail.
No! I've been reading my mail.
You can't read.
I read better than you.
Put her out of this house.
She'll be back. She ain't got nothing, cause she ain't nothing. See, sure got spunk. What do you got? You ain't got nothing. You ain't nothing but a dirty little housemaid.
Until you do right by me, everything you ever think about is gonna crumble.
Don't do it, Miss Sarah. Don't do it. He ain't even worth it. Don't trade places with where I'm at.
Come on, Sid. Come on.
You're poor! You're black! You're ugly! You're a woman!
I may be poor. I may be black. I may be ugly. And I may be a woman. But I'm here. I'm here.
Well, I could have enjoyed my time here such fine folk. But I think the time has been well spent here.
How's it going?
You are a poor black woman. I should have locked you up in my house and never let you out. Only to work.
The same jail you planned for me is gonna be the same one you rot in!
Come on, Miss Steely, let's go to the car.
Everything you've done to me has already been done to you.
God, that's so beautiful.
I can see it now. Look at the world. Look at all these people. I see it. I see purple. I see God. I see God!
Dear love, dear stars,
so much, the cast of The Color Purple. I'm not going to take the time to introduce everybody. We have a program, and thank you all so, so much for being with us. I hope that this was a blessing to your life as much as it was a blessing to mine. Thank you all, and Cindy and Leo with your feedback. Thank you all so much, and I wish y'all a great night. Thank you so much.